after you have your management in place, the next thing that you need to do is you need to look and find something that's going to motivate your dog to do the task that you're asking him for. Finding the right motivator for your dog is key to success. You have to have something that your dog's willing to work for and willing to try to figure out that puzzle. If you don't have something that's going to motivate your dog, then you're not going to get training done. We want to use something positive that our dog enjoys. We don't want him to learn behaviors by trying to avoid some kind of punishment, pain, or fear. We want to motivate him to want to learn, to want to try to figure out that puzzle. This will help build that connection between you and your dog's going to want to work with you. He's going to want to pay attention to you. He's going to think you're more exciting than that squirrel. And this is going to make those lessons fun and exciting for both you and your dog, which is going to make training happen much easier and much quicker. Finding a good motivator is something that your dog looks forward to, something that he might do flip-flops for, that he just can't get to fast enough. He gets to decide on what's motivating and not. So just because you found a treat in the pet store and you think, wow, that looks really good, it's 100% beef. Your dog, he may not like beef. He may not think that that's a great motivator. He gets to decide on what he's willing to work for. So at the beginning, you might try a lot of different things to figure out what that is. What is it that he wants to work for? What does he find very exciting? So food is one of those things that we can look at when we're motivating our dog. One of the things is that food our dog needs. He needs to eat every day. So instead of putting the food in the dog food bowl and letting him just scarf it down in 10 seconds, I'm going to use his food calories to teach him all those lessons that I'm trying to teach him. This is very helpful if you have a dog who's learning a lot of things. You get a new puppy and he's learning not to jump, he's learning to sit, he's learning to come when called, he's learning how to pay attention to his name. You need to reinforce those behaviors often, but we don't want to add extra calories because we don't want to end up having a fat puppy on our hands. So instead, you're going to kind of do a calorie count and figure out how many calories a day your dog's getting, and you're going to incorporate some food and some treats into those daily calories. If you're using things like cooked meats or even meat treats that are 100% meat, then you can count those treats towards his daily calories. If they're treats that have other ingredients inside them, like coconut flour or barley or brown rice, we want to think of those treats more on the line of treats, kind of like we might get a candy bar. So those treats really can't go towards his daily calorie count. They're just going to be extras, so we want to kind of limit those. So that's why personally I try to go towards meat, because again, my dog needs at least 70% meat, so I can easily incorporate those treats into his daily food calories. We can also use toys and games and attention as rewards as well, but we want to think about our dog and we want to think about the task at hand. So if I'm asking my dog to do a sit inside the living room and he's already kind of learned how to do a sit, then throwing him the tennis ball or giving him a scratch around his neck might be a good reward. But if I'm asking him to do a sit outside and there's another dog walking by or a squirrel that he's looking at, that reward might not be valuable enough to get him to do that behavior. So different behaviors need a different value system. The harder your dog thinks a task is, the better the value needs to be. So if we're asking our dog to do something he finds difficult, that reward needs to be really good. If we're asking him to do a task that he doesn't think of as too challenging, then that reward can be a little bit lower. If you're trying to use toys as a reward, the best way to make a toy motivating is to find something that he really enjoys and give him limited access to it. So if you find out that he really loves the squeaky rabbit toy, then he only gets the squeaky rabbit toy when you've asked him to do something and he's complied. Then he gets that reward. So it's not in his toy box. He only gets it for doing things for you. Then it's really valuable. When you're working with your dog, you want to have a wide variety of rewards. You also want to mix things up. So say you found out that your dog really loves cooked salmon. And you give him cooked salmon day in and day out for pretty much everything that he's done. Cooked salmon is no longer going to be as valuable as it was a week ago because he's gotten it every day. Just like I love chocolate cake, but if I had chocolate cake every day, it's not going to be as exciting. But if I only get chocolate cake once a month, when I get that chocolate cake, it's going to be really exciting and I'm really going to enjoy it. So you want to have a wide variety of different rewards to make it new and novel and exciting. Once you think you have a few rewards that you want to see how exciting they are to your dog, take those things outside. See how your dog responds in an outside environment. Because if you offer your dog a treat inside the house, he might scarf it down thinking, wow, that's really exciting. If you take that same treat outside and offer it to your dog, he might blow you off just to go sniff the dandelion. So that tells you that reward isn't as exciting as you thought it was. You want to find things that he finds really exciting outside in a hard environment, because that'll tell you how exciting that reward really is. Once you find a handful of really exciting rewards and you're trying to work with your dog and it still seems like he's kind of blowing you off or he seems a little confused, then you might need to make that environment a little easier. Maybe he's not quite ready for that environment. You want to make sure that your dog can learn and he can be successful. So you want to break that down a little bit so that you're just asking for little bits and not quite so stimulating environment. He needs to be successful in order to grasp the task at hand. So take it easy, find high value rewards, make sure you keep looking for new rewards so that we can keep all those training lessons fun and exciting and fresh, and you and your dog really look forward to your sessions.